one of his comrades killed the other, and Parabaquite tasted the truly savage joy of vengeance. But the poor mother could not be so comforted. After wandering through the rain all night, she reached the party as they were skinning the bear and dividing the flesh. Parabaquite only asked and obtained the skins to recompense him for the loss of his son. They returned home in triumph, Kanda following them with bitter cries, tearing her face with a shark's tooth. From observation of these circumstances, I concluded that Kanda must be the mother of my little child that I'd found. My heart sympathized with her, and I even made some steps forward to restore him. But the sight of the savage crowd, with their tattooed bodies, filled me with such terror that I retreated involuntarily to the grotto, where my children, alarmed by the noise, were hiding themselves.
"Why do the people cry out so?" said Sophia. "They frighten me. Don't let them come here, mamma, or they may carry Mino away."
"Certainly," said I, "and I should have no right to forbid them. I think they are his friends, who are distressed at losing him. I wish I could restore him to them."
"Oh, no, mamma," said Matilda. "Pray don't give him back. We like him so much, and we will be his little mammas. He will be far happier with us than with those ugly savages, who tied him up like a parcel in the bark, with the moss which pricked him so much. He's much more comfortable in my apron. How he moves his legs as if he wanted to walk! Sophia and I will teach him. Do let us keep him, Mimi.